remarkably generous.
Let's go to Dana Bash. Dana, what would you make of it?
Well, he's right.
You know, I think restraint is the
perfect word. Right. He need not.
That this is the
president's criticism of the Trump
Angry Obama.
Yeah. Yeah. True.
A few years ago, because you know that what is going on in his head is so
cord bomb.
He has to say, out of respect for the office that he holds and respect for the democracy that elected Donald Trump, he has to be on the straight and narrow. And that is precisely what we saw and heard him say time and time again. When journalists like Athena Jones and others were asking him really legitimate questions, considering how far out there he was in campaigning, not just for Hillary Clinton, but in a very raw, very harsh way against Donald Trump. But that was just today, and this is today, and you know, he is just trying to keep an upper lip, not just for the institution, as I said, but it's also
got
for
it.
People out there who
50% reduction in boss revive time. And
I think one of the things that had to have been motivating President Obama had to have been, what will my work mean?
Can I ask you a question?
How will they affect,
yes.
The country,
is there a reason why you won't start your homework?
Americans are scared.
No.
Do you want to be sitting there all night doing that homework?
Yeah.
No. Well, then why don't you start it? How many problems are there?
One more left.
One what?
One more question left.
Well, why don't you finish it and then leave it on the table for mom to check it? You don't know how proud she would be of you if you did that. You can't do it all for me. It's a human being.
So is God, but how did he do it all then?
Because he's God.
I know that.
That's her.
And trying to tear up the Iranian agreement.
Running 31 full-time.
He's not going to walk off the world stage and just let all these things be ripped apart. He will willingly engage in conversation and arguments with the American people. It is not wise to do these things. You're going to destabilize the world. He's going to be going and facing a group of Europeans when he gets to Europe in the next 24 to 36 hours. That's very, very skeptical. I was surprised, Frank, that he said he was going to bring a commitment to NATO from President-elect Trump. We haven't heard that from Mr. Trump.
Yay! Yay!